The Naval Research Laboratory's safety branch is saving the bay, one spat at a time. The Chesapeake Bay has long been considered one of America's most important natural resources. The bay has provided shelter, income, and food for generations of Americans. Over many years, however, life on and around the bay has grown crowded and more complex. Chemical runoff from factories and farms, and other contaminants in water drainage, all have a way of polluting the waters of our bay. This has left the bay in peril and in need of immediate action. NRL's safety branch is helping to turn back the clock on the years of abuse the Chesapeake has suffered by reestablishing the depleted oyster population. The oyster is a filter feeder, which means that it feeds by pumping large volumes of water through its gills. As oysters feed on plankton and other particles, they remove suspended sediments and chemical contaminants, keeping the bay clean. But the oyster is in serious decline. In the late 19th century, the oyster population could filter a volume of water equal to that of the entire bay every 3 to 4 days. Today's depleted population takes nearly a year to filter that same volume. That's where Kathy Edwards and Joe Polovich of NRL's safety branch have stepped in. These folks, along with members of the NRL Chesapeake Detachment, have partnered with the Department of Natural Resources to help clean the bay. They are doing this by establishing beds of larval oysters, called spat, at two NRL locations on the bay.
Spat are young oysters less than a year old. Here's a shell. It has 1, 2, 3, 4 spat. This one has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. None on that side, and a few here.
When full grown, these oysters will be transplanted to a location set aside as a safe haven to reestablish the oyster beds.
I'm Joe Polovich. I work at the Naval Research Laboratory. I did a search on the internet and I found Mr. Chris Judy's name, and he is the oyster program coordinator for the Maryland Department of Natural Resources Fisheries Department. One of the big problems with the bay is a lot of nutrients get into the bay, some of the pollution from cars, and all of these nutrients, the nitrogen, phosphorus, it comes from all these different sources, gets into the bay and it causes algae blooms. The algae grow out of control, and then when they decay, they eat up the dissolved oxygen. The fish need the oxygen in order to survive, and if they don't have that, they start dying off.
As the Defense Department's executive agent, the Department of the Navy is responsible for ensuring all of its 68 Department of Defense installations in the Chesapeake Bay watershed adhere to environmental and clean water standards. The Department of Defense has been working to improve the bay since 1984, when it was the first federal agency to become formally involved in bay restoration. NRL and the Department of Defense are doing their part to keep the Chesapeake Bay healthy and beautiful.